Oh, hey, Stephen, you look sick.
My schedule has been so hectic, I got a cold.
Oh, I think you should take some vitamin or what about orange?
Oh, I'll try that. Cheers.
Orange? Okay, I'll get one. Hello, everyone. This is Billy.
Hi, everyone. This is Stephen.
And today, we're going to take a look at some English words that are commonly mispronounced in Korean.
Billy's going to be giving you the Korean pronunciation, and I'll be giving you the British pronunciation.
Great. Let's take a look. 스케줄
schedule
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 So schedule, that sounds quite totally different from the Korean style of pronunciation, right?
Yeah, it's a little strange in British English, but we don't have any words that are SCH apart from schedule.
Okay.
So I think we pronounce it like chair or chin, things like that.
So you guys don't really pronounce like schedule?
No, that's like more the American way.
Okay. 비타민
Vitamin.
비타민.
Vitamin.
So that sounds a little bit similar to the Korean style pronunciation, but don't you guys also pronounce like vitamin or stuff like that?
Well, again, the Americans and Canadians say vitamin, but actually vitamin comes from vita, meaning life. So
oh,
we say
right.
vitamin.
Okay, so you're sticking to the original.
Exactly.
Orange.
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 So you pronounce like orange, but you don't really pronounce like orange, right?
No, again, it comes from the French, and the E is just a marker for the end of the word, so we never pronounce it.
So orange?
Always orange.
Orange? Jewelry.
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 So jewelry, right?
Well, no, in British English, the jewel is the part you stress in the word, so re just becomes one sound.
Okay.
Jewelry.
So not jewelry.
No,
like
too many sounds.
Okay. Aluminium.
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 Why not aluminum, but like aluminium?
This is actually to do to a spelling mistake.
Okay.
When the word was first invented, British writers put an extra I in. Americans only have one I, so they pronounce aluminum, but we pronounce aluminium.
So has it changed from aluminium to aluminum?
We just take both spellings.
Okay. Perma.
Perm.
Perma.
Perm.
I think perma is more like Japanese-style pronunciation, right?
But in British English, perm comes from the word permanent.
Okay.
So we use the same pronunciation, perm.
Because that is kind of like, that is kind of like permanently changed this
exactly.
hairstyle. Okay. 요구르트.
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 So when we say 요구르트 in Korean, it's more like the liquid one, but yogurt is not actually the liquid one, right?
No, and for British English speakers, yogurt is taken from the Turkish word, yogurt. So we use the same pronunciation, but I think Yakulta is a brand name.
Yakulta?
Think it's a brand.
So then do you have to specifically say liquid yogurt or something like that for yogurt drink?
Yogurt drink.
Yogurt drink. Curtain.
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 So curtain and curtain, I think that, you know, intonation or the accent is a bit different, right?
Yeah, I think curtain is quite difficult for a lot of people to pronounce, so they read it phonetically. But we understand.
Okay, so you understand curtain anyhow.
Exactly.
Okay. Copy.
Coffee.
Copy.
Coffee.
So you don't say like copy, is it more like coffee?
Yeah, you have to say coffee because copy means a duplicate of something. It's another word. And all European languages use the F sound. Cafe, coffee, tofon, all different words, but no, always coffee.
But in American English, it's more like coffee, right?
Yeah, the O changes.
Okay, so it's more like coffee?
Coffee.
Coffee, okay. Fork.
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 Like for Korean people, it's really hard to pronounce the F sound. So we just can't help pronouncing F like pork, something like that. But like, can you understand it?
I think if you went to a restaurant in the UK, they might get confused that you're asking for pork, the meat.
Oh, right.
So maybe you should always say knife and pork. Then they might understand.
Okay. So now we know how to correctly pronounce each word. Hope you guys enjoyed it.
Next time, we're going to be looking at foods that you might know the American word for, but not the British word.
Great. I'll see you next time. Bye.
Bye, everyone.